I've been waiting so many years for a company to actually mass produce this, and it just showed up today. This is a 1.7 cubic inch V8 overhead cam engine that runs on nitro, about 28 cc's. This thing looks absolutely incredible. Just an insane amount of detail. This has to be the craziest miniature engine that Toyan has came out with so far. Dual carburetors, overhead cams, a complete cooling system, electric starter. And this thing just comes 100% complete with headers and all. It even has mufflers. I'll show it to you next to a drill to give you a better idea of the size of this engine. So I'm just gonna jump right into it. Open this engine up, take a look inside and see how it's built. I especially want to see the main bearings underneath for the crankshaft. And then I'm going to set this thing up, start it up, and see if it sounds as mean as it looks. And I'm going to leave most of the grease in place, but let me spin this so we can see how it works. Feel the compression already. Feels pretty smooth. Now let me remove that oil pan and take a look at the crankshaft bearings. Here's inside of our crankcase, and this is the main thing I wanted to see. Looks like they learned from the L400, and this time they put a bearing on every single cap for the mains. That means I could rev this thing sky high and I shouldn't have to worry about breaking the crankshaft. And if you look closely there, you can see that they have a front and rear main oil seal. That's also good news because that means that there shouldn't be oil coming out of the actual crankcase cover. And the middle three bearings look like plain bearings, but I'm gonna pop this seal out and see if we can see inside of there. I think the front and the rear are actually ball bearings. Take a look inside of there. You can see that the front and rear bearings are ball bearings. There's two thrust bearings right here, which is really nice. Keeps the crankshaft from going back and forth. Connecting rods look like billet connecting rods. It's nice to see that the bottom end is built up like that. Should take a lot of abuse. Without further ado, let's get this thing started up. Here we go. I bled the cooling system the best I could and used this little overflow tank. Let's start it up and see how it sounds. Just like that, a whole tank of fuel is gone that fast. Wow, that did not sound like I thought it was gonna sound. It sounds like the engine is suffocating, like it wants to breathe so bad, but it just can't. So the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the back of that muffler off to make sort of a header collector and then start it up again, see how it sounds. I'm gonna cut this just like a Harley. That looks much better. I'm all done. Let's get this thing started. I'm gonna start it up like this with the open collectors and see how it sounds. And then I have one more idea in mind after this. Let's do it. Definitely sounds better. One thing that I do find about this engine, you have to let it warm up a bit before it stays idling. I guess just like a real V8. Ooh, that sucker smells hot. That was a full throttle run for an entire tank of fuel. And it smells a little burned up, but we hit 10,500 RPM is the maximum RPM. That thing is screaming. But yeah, that's how fast an entire tank of fuel burns up at full throttle. I don't know, what was that, like 30 seconds, 45 seconds? And this thing is hot. This thing is smoking. Our radiator feels pretty cool, but oh, the lines are really hot. And the engine, whoo, man, that engine's gotta be 250 degrees. And I do have a fan hooked up to the radiator right here with the overflow tank. We could see some steam inside of that overflow tank there. Yeah, that was the maximum RPM run, over 10,000 RPM. And it still doesn't sound like it's really breathing to me. I bet you I could hit 12,000 or 15,000 on this. I'm gonna do one more thing before I end this video. I'm gonna remove both of these exhaust headers, take off the valve cover, put the high-speed camera on this, and then do one more run to see if we can get it to be just a little bit louder and sound just more angry. Looks like the grease has settled down a bit from those runs. That's good. We'll have a nice clear look at the rockers, the buckets, and the cam with the high-speed camera. See how this thing sounds without the headers and how it looks without the valve covers. Here we go. I have to admit, that was pretty cool. This engine is legit. Not only did it start up and run straight out of the box, but it also ran at full throttle for over 3.5 minutes during this shoot, and it's still running right now. Not to mention, it hit over 10,000 RPM without even tuning it. So that right there is impressive. This engine is definitely a beast. And now there's oil everywhere. Yeah, this is a cool engine. I'll leave links to this engine in the description below, as well as a discount code. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. I really enjoyed that full throttle run and seeing that thing scream at over 10,000 RPM. I hope you did too. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.